Today, we're going to open the case of an HP Pavilion Model 690-24. This Ryzen 5-based gaming desktop is compact in size, but we'll see if it has some room for upgradeability. I'll dismantle the case and the inner cage to assess how much you can upgrade in terms of processor, graphics card, memory, and storage. On paper, the HP contains an AMD Ryzen 5 2400G running at 3.6 GHz with 8 GB of DDR4 memory running at 2666 MHz. It includes an AMD Radeon RX 580 graphics card and three drives, a 128 GB SSD, a 1 TB hard drive, and a DVD-CD burner. The case itself is black brushed metal with green LED highlights, and it's really compact. It measures approximately 13.5 inches high by 6¾ wide by 10¾ deep, which means there's not a lot of room in there. So I'm curious how upgradable this system really is. Let's open the case and find out. The tools you need are a flathead or Torx screwdriver, an old credit card or gift card, and finally an ESD strap or ESD mat if you plan to touch any of the electronics inside. The first thing you'll need to do is remove the single screw that secures the cover. You can use either a flathead or Phillips head screwdriver, so I'll just use my flathead bit. The screw itself isn't meant to be detached from the cover, so you can leave it in place after loosening it. Let's then remove the side panel and set it aside and take a look inside the case. At first glance, it looks very clean. The cables are well organized. At this point, to avoid any electrostatic damage, I'll put on my ESD wrist strap before touching any internal components. To get to the memory, M.2 slot, and the storage devices, we'll need to remove the cage, which is held in place by these four screws. They're a Torx flathead hybrid, so you can use either screwdriver bit. I'll just switch over to my Torx bit to unscrew them. When I try to slide the cage, there's some resistance, and that's because the front bezel of the CD-DVD drive is preventing its removal. All you need to do is take a plastic card and wedge it in the spacing between the bezel and the front cover. When you pry it, it'll pop right off. Here, you can see the tabs that held it in place. The cage then simply slides off like this. Make sure not to yank it off because there are plenty of cables attached. Peering inside the case, there's the processor, which is an AMD Ryzen 5 2400G. It's an AM4 socket, so you could upgrade to a Ryzen 7 2700, according to HP's website. HP has decided to pair this APU, which has integrated Radeon RX Vega 11 graphics, with a discrete graphics card, the AMD Radeon RX 580 with 4 GB of memory. Note that if the graphics card ever breaks down, you won't be able to use the integrated graphics anyways, as the motherboard doesn't support it. It's a very short card, so you'd need to find one with similar dimensions if you wanted to upgrade it. There's a little more space toward the front of the case, but not much. Keep in mind that the power supply is only 400 watts, so you'll need to consider the power requirements of any graphics upgrade. There are two DIMM slots for DDR4 memory, and one is already taken. That one is an 8 GB module. You can add another one in the extra slot, or if you want to go large, it'll accept two sticks of 16 for a total of 32 GB. Next to the memory is the M.2 SSD in its slot. It's an NVMe SSD that's 128 GB, so it's not very large. You can always upgrade the SSD to a larger capacity. Panning over to the expansion slots, there's one single open PCIe slot, so you could possibly add an audio card. The HP comes with a mechanical 1 TB hard drive as its secondary drive, as well as a CD-DVD drive, both of which reside inside the cage. I'll go ahead and remove the SATA power and the SATA data cable that's attached to the hard disk. The disk itself is fastened to the cage by these four screws, which again are the Torx flathead hybrid, the same size as the cage screws I removed previously. The disk will slip right out. It's a Western Digital Blue running at 7200 RPM. You can swap this out with a larger hard drive or an SSD, but keep in mind that HP stores its recovery partition there. So you'll want to either make an image of that partition or create a set of recovery disks so you can get rid of that partition altogether. There's one more SATA port on the motherboard, so you can add another hard drive or 2.5-inch SSD if you want to expand your storage options. You can mount the additional drive on the cage, where a spare SATA power cable is conveniently within reach. If it's a 2.5-inch disk, you may need an adapter to mount it. Now, all we need to do is reverse the steps to reassemble everything back together. This is a very capable gaming machine that could see some immediate benefits with some minor upgrades. Even in this compact space, there are options to upgrade the computer, including its processor and graphics card, but more easily, its memory and storage. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.